to That's a Wrap, the channel where I review TV shows, movies, and movie trailers. But today, on this very special episode, we are going to do a recap or just an overall review of the mega hit Disney Plus sensation brought to us by Marvel Studios, WandaVision. But before I get into the recap or my praise of this awesome mini-series that we all got to enjoy, if you are enjoying the content, please feel free to like the videos, subscribe to the channels, and hit that bell for notifications. And if you haven't seen WandaVision, aren't familiar with what I'm talking about, why did you click on this video? What are you doing? Get Disney Plus, get someone's login, and watch that series. It's gold. You will enjoy it. And even if you are one of those fans that your theories didn't come true, just like some of mine didn't come true, you will still enjoy it. So take that for what it is and consider that long introduction your spoiler warning. So on to the recap / review. I have a playlist with all the episodes, all my breakdown, theories, and everything you could think of with this series. I actually started my channel with WandaVision being the first TV show that I actually started to review, and let me tell you, it didn't disappoint. I have been singing the praises of this series since the first two episodes aired. I just thought the way they captured the essence of what TV sitcoms, just what they have meant to the overall identity of not only us throughout or us here in the United States, but let's just call it the world. The impact that some of these TV series like I Love Lucy, like Bewitched, like Malcolm in the Middle. So just some of the examples or some of the ideas that were brought to life in this miniseries, I think was brilliant. And we're starting to see some of the accolades starting to come their way, which they are very well deserved. Everything that is coming to the actors, producers, writers, costume, whatever awards they get, they deserve it. They should be sweeping every kind of award wherever they can. And I've repeated this and echoed this in almost every one of my reviews. The acting by the stars and the co-stars, the extras, was brilliant. The vision, pun intended, that Marvel had for us and the way they put it out for us to enjoy, I mean, was breathtaking. The amount of love that you see online, whether it be Facebook groups, whether it just be normal Facebook, the art, TikTok, the just popular media have taken it. I mean, I've seen the late night shows embrace it. And from the beginnings, that there were some even YouTubers that were questioning how good this was going to be because Wanda and Vision weren't fully developed characters in the Infinity Saga. Yes, there was obviously the origin story, or what we considered the origin story, or our introduction to Wanda Maximoff and her brother and the creation of Vision in the Age of Ultron story, and obviously in Civil War and so on and other, but they weren't fully fleshed out. They weren't the center of stories. So a ton of YouTubers, a ton of websites, a ton of people in the industry talked down about this series, were completely negative about the series. I even know, which I'm not going to say name because this is not about bashing anyone or any channel or any outlet or any website. But the lack of respect that they had for Marvel Studios, even though they gave us 23 films of nothing but entertainment, and they couldn't even give it a little bit of that slack or a little bit of that, hey, let's give it a shot. They were like, I'm not going to waste my time on it. Oh, I don't get why these, you know, two characters got their own, you know, their own spinoff. There's so many other characters that they could have taken it. I mean, when it was announced that it was gonna, that there was gonna be this show, WandaVision, so many people, so many videos, some have taken it down since the popularity of WandaVision has basically consumed the world from every market, everywhere. Some have taken it down, but some have have sang the praises once they started to see just the production value, the storytelling. I said it in my first couple of videos. Marvel Studios is in a different league when it comes to storytelling. The way they grabbed these two characters and made us fall in love with the love story, and then to take us on this amazing journey to see the depths of what Wanda was dealing, her loneliness, her sorrow, her pain, and how they still managed to keep us week to week so excited, so ready to just stay up at midnight if you were on the West Coast, and some people were devoted at 3 o'clock in the East Coast religiously to watch this miniseries, shows you just the brilliancy that we watch. And I don't think I'm overpraising it. I think I'm just, it's just right with the amount of praise. We haven't seen something like this ever done. There might be, you know, some examples that might have come close, but what Marvel Studios presented, I don't think there's something that we could point and say, yeah, you know what, this is similar to that. This is, you know, or this kind of reminds me of that. The way Kevin Feige did, and it kind of wrapped up a love letter. And then I'm not taking that. That's not my line. I saw that actually in an article a couple days ago. They called it a Marvel's love letter to sitcoms, which it was. The homage that they paid to these amazing sitcoms, the amalgamation, not just one or two, just it was, for at least the most part, it was an amalgamation of several influential sitcoms, and they combined them to pay tribute to just Hollywood, or old school Hollywood, or just Hollywood in general. And what, again, how I started off the sitcom and how it is so important to us, how it's molded us as generations, as a species, that's just who we are. I mean, I could look over at my DVD collections, and I have Big Bang Theory. I have Modern Family, which was one of the examples. I have How I Met Your Mother, that 70s show, Game of Thrones, Gilligan's Island, I Love Lucy. I mean, the list goes on and on. And I am, in just like everyone else, a fan of good TV cinema. And this is what we got. We got 9 episodes of nothing but brilliancy. The way they interwove those sitcoms and then gave us that emotional story between Wanda and Vision and made us care so much. From the theme songs, the WandaVision, WandaVision, and then obviously the one that blew up, that's number one right now, being played, Agatha All Along. I mean, it couldn't get more brilliant. Some of the, I the last thing I would have ever have thought is cheering up at Wanda and Vision's relationship and their struggles and everything they went through. Yet I found myself so emotionally attached to this TV series. And again, that just speaks to everyone involved. From just the smallest person, from the props, to the ones that got the actors the coffee. The brilliancy in the acting. I said it in a ton of videos that it was on another level. The way that the stars, Wanda and Vision, the actors that played them, the way, and not only those two, the supporting cast in those first three episodes when we were flashing back to the black and white era, and then we jumped into the Brady Bunch era. The way they were able, week to week, to show us what acting was like every different decade was brilliant. Show me a work of anyone that resembles that kind of brilliant acting. And this probably was the other shining bright light that we got to see acting in its highest form from everyone involved. Yes, there was a little gaps in certain parts. I attributed that to the coronavirus and the pandemic that we're in. There had to be cuts in production, and anyone that knows, when you're in a flow state, you want to stay in that flow state. And it's hard when, unfortunately, through this pandemic, the shooting had to stop. The production had to come to a halt to allow for, you know, quarantine to happen in case someone came up with the coronavirus, or, you know, there were obviously, wherever they were at, new restrictions happened, so they had to abide by certain laws. But just what we've become accustomed to because of this pandemic. So I attributed some of the lags because of that. You know, it's hard. It's hard to come in and out of a flow state. And if you've ever been in those states where you're just focused and everything coming out is just bam bam hitting every note, and then stopping, it's so hard to get it back. But even in saying that, the way they were able to grab that right back after a little bit, it wasn't like, oh, it wasn't overly glaring. Like, it wasn't something that you were like, wow, that really got, you know, the whole, you know, 22 minutes or 25 minutes or whatever minutes. It was just in little spots. But those first three episodes, I've said it and I'll keep on saying it. Those first three episodes, pick an episode and put that up in whatever awards show. Split them up and spread them on every awards show. Those should win. The acting, the props, the attention to detail was on another level. And I, for one, think that everyone that's criticizing it because of the theories, the fan theories that didn't come through true, is just... That's the only negative part about all this that I could really nitpick, and it has nothing to do with the show. It's us as fans that are tainting this magnificent series that we saw because certain, you know, theories didn't come true, because we are so influenced by YouTube channels that put out these ridiculous and far-fetched theories, and who's gonna come up and what does this mean, and they hype everyone up to have these expectations. So then when the expectations don't get met, they are the drum that beats that, oh, it's not satisfying, it wasn't this. Instead of seeing the work for what it is, an independent gold, independent shining star that needs to be judged not on your expectations. Oh, it was, should have been Mephisto. Oh, the X-Men didn't get introduced. Oh, you know, the Fantastic Four weren't even blah, blah, blah. Anything. All that stuff is just murking the water in what otherwise should be nothing but brilliance. when you just dissect it without any expectations of what you're as a standalone project. How can you judge it anything other than the phenomenon that it is? Unseen, unprecedented. Okay, this is not an established Batman or Superman or Iron Man or whatever kind of freaking property that you know, Harry Potter. These were two characters that no one cared about. I know people that watch that Infinity War scene where Wanda's bawling because she has to destroy Vision. They didn't even get that part. They were like, I don't know why they focused on that. Like, we didn't even care. I didn't even care. I was like, okay, she has to sacrifice because, you know, he's made out of the Mind Stone and she has to, like, destroy it. Everyone was okay with that. No one cared. Or there was very few people. There wasn't all this fan art. There wasn't all this discussion back then. Like, oh, I feel really bad for Wanda. Nothing. It went away. We all felt bad for Tony Stark in Endgame. We all felt bad for Thor for not going for the head. We felt bad for the people that got snapped away. But it wasn't about Wanda or Vision. And look at what it is now. As we sit here on the... for this recording will be the 9th of March. Look at how it's such a... how people cry. The artwork, the remixes to the song, the merchandise. I don't know if Kevin Feige or Disney or Marvel knew that this was gonna happen, but if they didn't, wow, was this a pleasant surprise. And just, they must feel so empowered to say, we can do nothing wrong. Like, I remember this one channel called them like the Golden Gods. Like, they're at this point, Phase 4, they're just like the Golden God. They can't do nothing wrong. But honestly, can you blame them? This thing was brilliant. And fight me on it. Argue with me. Tell me it's not. Tell me it's something different. And don't attach your fanboydom to this. I'm a fanboy too. We all are. But don't attach any expectations about the Mephisto and what didn't come out in this theory and this other theory. I mean, there was theories that literally big channels that have over 6 million or 4 million views and followers and subscribers, within like 4 hours, they were wrong. The only good part about it is, for the most part, and I'll say this to redeem us fans and some of the content creators just like myself, that we put all these theories out there and that we were completely wrong, is that several of them have come out and say, hey, you know what? The bad reviews or the bad talk about this were all done by us. We perpetuated this kind of thinking. We're the ones that took it this far. We're the ones that are leading to this negative reviews. I mean, I saw someone talking about, the rating went down from Rotten Tomato, 81% on Rotten Tomato. That's still a high rating, but it was only knocked down because of the expectations of the ninth episode. The same thing with the Game of Thrones. Whether you agreed with the last, you know, season or not, whatever. It was always like 99. Everybody loved it, but just because everyone's theories went to crap, no one, you know, I'll get to Game of Thrones in future when I start doing my evaluation of that TV series, when I get to that Game of Thrones. But it was the same thing. Just because people weren't excited, or things that they thought because they were following this channel and he said that, hey, this and this is gonna happen, then when it didn't happen, all of a sudden it was like, oh no, it sucked, it was this, it was that, oh blah 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 blah. And that's what I've seen. And I still even seen some YouTube channels, but I've been so like controlling my typing hands because I want to reply so bad, or even put out a video, which I am going to put out a video about critics and how they ruin stuff. You know, luckily this mini series had enough hype, had enough facts, or just actual credibility of how amazing it was, that when you hear, I'm glad that when I see people talking bad about WandaVision, that there's this onslaught. And it's not about being a fan and being just a homer. It's that you recognize the brilliant. But again, giving credit where credit is due is that several of these content creators, including myself, have come out and say, hey, our theories were wrong. We were incorrect. Hey, we're huge fans just like you guys, and we get excited, and of course we're gonna theorize. It's what makes this community great. It's what makes reviewing movies like this great. It's what makes the theories. I mean, the in my channel, my highest viewed ones have been theories where you wanna know it. The speculation of what's coming next is so intriguing. And it's basically around Marvel, but because of Marvel's huge success with this, other studios and other projects want that same kind of hype. And I'm glad that I see them coming out and saying, hey, let's pause. It's on us. We're the ones that did it. Hey, I'm not gonna say names because I don't want to do that anyways, and I'm not a big enough channel to even start saying that. But I belong to a lot of Facebook groups. I get on YouTube just like every other freaking human. And when you hear the regurgitation of words and information, and they mentioned certain channels, oh, I thought it was Mephisto because of this channel. I thought Fantastic Four was gonna come because I heard of this guy, you know, from this channel say this, this and that. And all these channels knows who they are. But I was glad when they came out and started saying, hey, no, we take ownership. Some of this bad talk of WandaVision is because we wanted to see something. And they have a huge platform with huge following. And guess what? When we're in this industry, or not in this industry, but when you're in the field of theorizing with such a popular product, a popular IP, stuff's going to happen. So I was glad that is happening and it's continuing to happen. But honestly, if you take that away, tell me what's wrong with this show. Besides your nitpicking about your theories, honestly, what is wrong with this show? For me, 10 out of 10, it should not even be up for discussion as what is the best. And I know it's early on. I don't think I'm going to see anything better than this. And I'm putting this up with Game of Thrones, with Friends, with some of the popular TV sitcoms that I've seen. And bar none, I have not seen anything to the quality, to the emotional gravitas that this had. And again, let me know what's better than this. So I will sing this praise for the rest of this year. That there we will not see. I don't care if Black Widow comes out or the Zack Snyder cut or maybe some other off the wall comedy that might come up or TV drama or whatnot. Nothing. Not Chucky the TV horror miniseries. I don't think. And honestly, I don't think we're ever going to do this or we're ever going to see something like this. For Marvel Studios or for any studio to take that big of a shot, that big of a risk with this miniseries and the way they hit it out of the park, I don't think any other studio has the galls, has the stones to do that. But hey, this is just my opinion. You guys let me know in the comments if I'm right. Am I going too much? Fanboy, do you guys let me know another TV series, TV sitcom, TV drama, TV horror, TV whatever that is up to the par of this miniseries, 9 episodes, and it was pure gold. So my recap, my review was that this is brilliant. And if somehow Hollywood, I know they have a bias against superhero movies, except for the Black Panther, but if they have any biases, it's going to be shown here, because this was not only a tribute to Hollywood, and not just a tribute like, hey, here we go, you know, they did such a great job honoring Hollywood. The acting, the props, the sets, everything was brilliant. So I expect nothing but for Hollywood to reward Not because Marvel deserves it. No one deserves anything. But when you do something so brilliant, you deserve everything. With that said, I hope you guys enjoyed this little recap. I can't wait to rewatch them again for the 100th time, but let me know your thoughts in the comments. And like always, have a blessed night, and that's a wrap.